We have great expectations in crop 11 because normally our wetlands are diminishing day by day. It is only because the population is increasing and people are using wetlands mainly as a commodity, business commodity. So it is day by day it is completely diminishing and destroyed. So what we are intending to do is that there should be a participatory management program in which the local community and stakeholders are involved. Unless otherwise, even though there are many laws, even in India, we are having environmental protection laws, EPA, and also CRZ rules, Coastal Regulation Zone Acts. Even though there are such many type of laws, even then there is a frequent destruction of this mangrove wetlands. So our aim, yesterday we had one side event here, the OISCA International had organized that one, and in that we made a very good discussion. In that discussion, we came into the conclusion that the present scenario, which gives a threat to our humankind also due to climate change. The IPCC, Intergovernmental Panel for Climate Change, and also UNFCCC, they were making many discussions how to overcome or mitigate the climate change problem. But to this wetland and mangroves, it is proved to be a place where they can sequester the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere to the soil level. So mangroves are actually necessary. Mangrove wetlands are necessary in that respect. Even otherwise, the tsunami, we remember that very bad situation happened in 2004 due to the tsunami. But after tsunami, we made many experiments, many comparisons, and found that this mangroves wetlands actually form a barrier which protect us from the tsunami and cyclone and many other disasters. So how they are destroyed? It is destroyed only due to the fact that people does not know what is the importance of it. They don't know the value. They found that it is only a nasty place that should be converted into a concrete building, etc. So we have to make awareness to the local people. So the international community, after the COP11, the CBD, what the CBD has to do is they have to declare such sites as World Heritage Sites. We are thinking like that, World Heritage, and give training to the local people how to utilize this for the benefit of themselves. They can earn money out of that. Then they will come forward to protect. It is there in our area. We have made some sample test in our area. There is a place where there is a large number of migratory birds are coming. So the people are trained to receive the people. They come for ecotourism in that area. And they can make, by using the grasses, they can make some toys like things, and they can sell it to the those people. And also there is a kaipad cultivation. Kaipad cultivation means a special type of agricultural farming of rice, where some important species of rice varieties are used, having very tasty rice it gives. And that method is completely devoid of chemical fertilizers and pesticides, insecticides, etc. So such a type of activities, if you can encourage the people to do such a type of activities, that will yield. That means the people will come forward to protect. It happens there. So the OISCA, yesterday's discussions, we came to know that the participatory management, stakeholder development, and also the capacity building, and similar to that, the government or the international community should try to declare these sites. There are Ramsar sites. Ramsar sites are there, but Ramsar sites includes only the wetlands. Even the mangroves are there. Coming together, we have to declare it as the World Heritage Sites. That is the thing.
Sir, you've been involved significantly in educational programs as well. What sort of positive impact has it been able to yield so far? And do you think that it needs... What other things needs to be done to make the efforts more effective?
So from the grassroots level, it should be disseminated. that from the school children itself, we have to provide awareness campaign. See, OISCA is having children forest program. We are also having that type of the what you call Love Green Clubs, Save Green Clubs. The Love Green Clubs are there in schools. Save Green Clubs are there in colleges. And the Youth Forum is there in universities. So these type of forums, they will work grassroots level so that the people will get make, you can make aware of the importance of these mangrove wetlands and also the serious threat due to the destruction. And so society will be getting aware of the importance.